Hello, I hope you're doing fantastic. Thank you so much for joining me in this tutorial. So what we're going to do here is we are going to download, install, and set some preferences for the Arduino IDE on a PC. I'm running this on a computer that is a Windows 8 machine, maybe like 8.1 or something like that. So I know Windows 10 is just coming out, and maybe by the time you're listening to it, it's like Windows 2000, but I think in most cases, it's going to be pretty similar from one Windows box to the next. So the first thing you want to do is jump on the internet with your favorite browser and navigate to arduino.cc. Now, the website might look a little different than it does now. They change it from time to time, but you should be able to find a downloads tab. So go ahead and click on the downloads tab. That brings you to the download the Arduino software page. Now, you got a couple options here. Basically, you can download the Windows installer or a Windows zip file if you're a non-admin. We're going to demonstrate the Windows installer's route because I think that's, in most cases, what you're going to want. The other option you have is to get kind of the razor-sharp release of the Arduino IDE, and that's down by the hourly build section. So if you want the most recent thing that's been updated, you can download that and use it. But we're going to go with the Windows installer option. So go ahead and click on the Windows installer link, and it takes you to a contributions page. So you can decide if you want to contribute to the Arduino cause. It's a great idea if you do. I'm going to be cheap and just hit just download. Now it's going to ask you where you want to save this zip file. It really doesn't matter where you save it. I'm just going to save it to my downloads folder. And it starts to download. Now it's not too big of a file. It's like 77.7 megabytes for this current release. And I've got a normal cable internet connection, so it really didn't take too long to download. So once the file is done downloading, you can go ahead and double click on that executable file, and it's going to open up a couple windows. So the first thing it's going to ask is depend on whether or not you already have a older version of Arduino installed. If you already have an older version of Arduino installed, it's going to say, hey, you've got this old version on, do you want us to uninstall it? So when you uninstall it, it's just going to get rid of that version. It's not going to get rid of your sketch folder. So if you don't even know what that means, don't even worry about it. In other words, it's okay to just install that new version. So go ahead and click OK if this is the case for you, and it will run you through an uninstallation process. So once you've completely uninstalled it, you can click OK, and then you can close that uninstall box, and then you agree to the new license. Basically says you owe Arduino your children. Then you can set some preferences. Yeah, I just leave all these checked usually. And then finally, you select the install location. And usually, I just put it right into my programs folder. And then it just starts extracting, and that's really it for the installation. It does take a little longer than I would expect, maybe a minute or two, to install the whole package. So once it's installed, we're going to go ahead and open up the Arduino IDE. You can either use the desktop icon, or you can go to your programs folder and use the icon in there. And we're going to set some preferences. So you'll go up to File, Preferences. And I want to talk about some of the preferences that we can set here. Probably the most important thing to look at is this first line right here. And this is the sketchbook location. So when we write a program in the Arduino IDE and we save it, it's called a sketch. And all the sketches that we write and save, they end up in the sketchbook. Now, the sketchbook is like an easy place. It's like an easy repository to go and get all your sketches from. And the default location is usually under Users, the User, the Documents folder, and then a folder is created that's named Arduino. So if yours does not look like this, or if you would prefer that this folder be in a different place, you can browse and you can select a different place where you would like it to be put. I would recommend just using that. I would definitely recommend using a folder named Arduino, and this default location has worked pretty well for me. So the editor language, you can pick from a bunch of different languages. I'm using English, and the editor font size. So I prefer a larger font. 18 works pretty well for me. I think the standard it comes at is 12. Sometimes if you make the font too big, you'll see that one line actually gets written over top of the other. So you want to keep an, you might have to play around with that to see the optimal font size. So the other things I think are good to have selected in the preferences are displaying the line numbers. Those are just the lines over on the left side of the Arduino IDE. Verifying the code after upload, that won't mean anything now, but I think it's a good reason to have that clicked. We'll talk about it later. Check for updates on startup. You can check this or uncheck this. Again, it depends on whether you've decided to keep the current version of the IDE, like for example, the one that we're using in the course 1.6.5, or if you just want the most updated version, you can keep that clicked. I'd also recommend keeping the update sketch files to new extension. Basically what this is talking about is when you save an Arduino sketch, or again, an Arduino sketch is just an Arduino file, you know, like .doc for document, for a Microsoft Word document, for example. So it used to be .pde for Arduino sketch files, but now the file extension is .ino, .eno. So sometimes you'll come across some .pde files, and what this is saying is, hey, it'll just convert those files into .ino files. Really not too big of a deal, but it's handy to have clicked. And then finally, I think having the last one clicked is a good idea too. That's just save when verifying or uploading. And again, we'll talk about verifying and uploading in depth, but it's always good, in my opinion, to save as frequently as possible. And this just creates another save point for you. Okay, so now what if, say, for example, you wanted to stick with version 1.6.6? For you, if there is, you know, you're in the future, I'm like a person from the past talking to you. That's kind of interesting. Anyway, so when you come to the download page, this might be Arduino version 1.8.7 or 1.6.9 or like 14.8.7. Who knows how far in the future you are, future person. Anyway, so you're just going to go over to the previous releases and you'll click on the previous version of the current releases. And you'll see they list all of the previous releases going back. So if we wanted to get 1.6.3, again, you're just choosing your operating system. They've got Windows, Mac, and Linux. You choose it, and it's going to be the exact same process as before. You can see they've been very diligent in saving previous versions. All right. Hey, see you in the next video. Bye.